This video tutorial I will explain how to connect Mongo database with Spring Boot. Here you can see Spring Boot application, and it has a user controller which talks to user service, and user service talks to user repository, and user repository is responsible for communicating with Mongo database. Left side you can see Postman, and Postman will send user details as a JSON format, and user JSON will come to Spring Boot application, and Spring Boot will convert user JSON to user object and pass it to user controller, and user controller will pass user object to user service. User service will pass user object to user repository, and user repository will save user object as a document in Mongo database. We will see this flow next. In left side you can see Mongo database demo project and its directory structure. The step one is add dependencies. In pom.xml file we have to add Spring Boot starter data MongoDB and Spring Boot starter web. These two dependencies we have to add. Here you can see pom.xml file. And here you can see the two dependencies which we have discussed are here. The second step is configure Mongo database connection. That we can configure in application.properties file, and we have to specify Mongo database host name, which is nothing but localhost, because in my system it is installed. And the second one is port number. The default port number is 27017 for Mongo database, and then we have to specify the database name. So database name I have specified order. Inside resources folder you can see application.properties file, and here you can see MongoDB connection properties. There are some important parameters that we need to know to connect to the Mongo database server with the Spring Boot application. The first one is port number. By default port number is 27017. The second one is host name. By default host name is localhost. The third one is database name, and the fourth one is credential. Credential is nothing but username and password. If Mongo database is configured with username and password, then this credential we have to provide. Otherwise it is optional. And we have seen in application.properties we have to set host, port, database. And if username and password is configured in Mongo database, then we have to provide these two key value pairs, username and password for Mongo database. We can connect Mongo database by providing this set of key value pairs, or we have to provide URI of Mongo database like this: MongoDB colon double slash username password at hostname port number, then the database name. And in this case order is the database name, and suppose if username and password is not there, then we can provide URI like this: MongoDB colon localhost colon port number 27017 slash order is nothing but the database name. Step 3 is create a Mongo database entity. First we have to define Mongo database entity class that represents document in your Mongo database collection. Then we have to annotate the class with @document. Then we have to define the fields and their mappings. And you have to remember your class name will be your collection name, and your variables will be your column name when it will be created in your database. And here you can see the example. Here we have defined the user class and annotated with @document. It has three fields: user ID, name and age. Here I have defined the class user and annotated with @document, and here you can see the three fields: user ID, name and age. and user ID I have annotated with at ID. So user ID will be unique and it will be auto generated. The step 4 is define MongoDB repository. In this step, we have to create a MongoDB repository interface by extending Mongo repository interface. The Mongo repository interface is provided by Spring Data MongoDB. And with the help of this interface, we can perform CRUD operation in our database. And here you can see user repository interface, which extends Mongo repository. And here we have given the domain class name. The string is nothing but user ID data type, which is unique and it will be auto-generated. And if you see that user class, we have annotated with at ID. Here you can see user repository interface, which extends Mongo repository interface. And here you can define custom queries, or we can use default CRUD operations provided by Mongo repository. The step 5 is use MongoDB repository. In this step, we have to inject MongoDB repository into the Spring Boot service class and use that MongoDB repository to perform database operations. Here you can see I have defined user service class, and here I have injected user repository object, and here I am using for CRUD operation. Here I have defined the class user service, and here I have auto-wired user repository object. Using addUser method, we can create a new user, and using getAllUser method, we can get all the user details from the Mongo database. The step 6 is define controller class which uses service class. We will create a controller class. From there, we will perform a CRUD operation in our database. And we have to annotate controller class with @RestController. And here you can see, I have defined the class UserController. And I have applied @RestController annotation. And here I have auto-wired UserService object. And it has two methods. First method is addUser method. Using that, we can create the user. And the second method is getAllUser method. Using that, we can get all the users from the database. Here I have defined the class MongoDB demo application, which is a Spring Boot application. Now I am going to start this Spring Boot application. And the Spring Boot application has been started in port number 8080. Here you can see in Mongo database, there are 4 databases are there, and you can see order database is not there. I have started Spring Boot application, and the Spring Boot application is connected to Mongo database. And now what I will do is, I will open Postman and send user details to Spring Boot application. And the Spring Boot application will store the user details into Mongo database. That we will see. To call addUser method of UserController, we have to use this path /addUser, and HTTP method should be post, and we have to pass user details in JSON format. Here you can see the Postman console, and here you can see the URL to add the user, and HTTP method is post, and here we have to select raw, and data format we have to select as JSON. And in the body, I am sending the user details in JSON format. Name is Arun and age is 44. Click on send. And here we got the output. The user is successfully added in Mongo database. And this is the unique ID, user ID, which is auto-generated. And name is Arun, age is 44. And status code is 200, which means it is successful. Click on refresh. And here you can see, order database is created. in that user collection is created, and user collection has one document, which is Arun details. We will create one more user information. Name is John, age is 23. Click on send, and here you can see the one more user is created. Click on refresh, and here you can see the details of John is created. To call this get all user method of user controller, we have to use this path get all user, and HTTP method should be get, and this method returns all the user in the user collection. Here you can see the URL to get all the user, and HTTP method should be get. Click on send, and here we got HTTP status code as 200, which means it is successful. And in response, we got array of users. And this is the first user information. The username is Arun. This is second user information. The username is John. You can get the Java source code link from the description section of the video. To see the description in mobile, click on this icon and it will expand like this. Then click on this more button to see the description. And in the description, you can see the links. And click on these links to get the Java source code.